Hello everyone, welcome to another session. Today we're gonna learn how to install Helm tool on K3s cluster. In my previous video, I have already explained how to install and configure K3s on a Linux machine, and also provided this article which explain all the advantages and also the system requirements, and then obviously step by step clear instruction how to install and configure it. And you can follow this if you are new to K3s, and for those who even do not know K3s, well, K3s is a very powerful but yet lightweight Kubernetes cluster which is officially created by Rancher, and it is backed by CNCF. It is basically a CNCF project, and it is really lightweight, and you can do a lot of things easily. The traditional way to install a Kubernetes cluster is basically to install and configure each step manually, and it creates a lot of errors, a lot of problem with the configuration. With K3s, you can basically install it with just single command. So it is really easy and yet very powerful. So this is my K3s cluster up and running, and I can confirm with this using kubectl cluster info command. Yep, it looks good. And also if I type kubectl version command, you can see that it shows both client and the server version, and in both cases you can see that it is integrated with K3s. So this is perfect. But when I type the Helm command, nothing will comes up, and this is because that when we install the K3s, by default K3s does not come or ship with Helm itself. To install the Helm, we have to do it manually, and based on the documentation provided by the K3s, this says that for tools like Helm, and in some cases if you're installing kubectl in a customized way and you want to integrate it, you have to use the kubeconfig file, which is stored at a specific location, and export it as an environment variable. And after that, you can use the Helm command and it will work correctly with K3s. So the first thing we need is to install the Helm tool itself. For that, I will go to the Helm website and use the Helm installation guide. And I will use the script method. I feel it is really easy. So the first thing is that I will copy paste this and paste here. And it seems fine. Then give it the appropriate permissions. And finally run it. It is downloading the Helm tool itself, and it seems it has been already done. Now if I type Helm command, it gives me something, but it will not work correctly. To make it working correctly, we have to follow the K3s cluster access documentation. So we will use the first method using the environment variable, where we'll export a variable called kubeconfig and use this path. This path is the path to the kubeconfig file, which is stored at k3s.yaml in the etc directory of Rancher. So let's do this and clear the screen and paste here. Okay. Now we will run this command. Basically, it's the kubectl get pods from all namespaces. So basically, it will return us all the pods from all the namespaces. And now we can see that it is running everything. Okay. And if I do now Helm list all from all namespaces, it should now be working correctly. And it does. So this is what we are looking for. And to make sure that Helm is really up and running and working correctly, we can do a small test. We go to the Artifact Hub website, and let's say that we want to install WordPress. Okay, so this is the WordPress Helm repo, and to install it, we will first add the repo itself. So we add it here. Okay. And now let's update it. Okay, and now it says if we need to install the WordPress, we can use this command. So let's copy this. Okay, and in this case, it's installing version 23.9. We don't need the specific version. We can just trim it out to something like this. Okay. Now it seems that the WordPress is successfully installed. We can see the status is deployed. Right, and this is the chart name, and this is the deployment name, and these are the chart and app versions. And if we do Helm list all, or it's Helm list, in this case it's a default namespace, so we don't need to provide the namespace, but we can see that WordPress is up and running. And let's test it out by removing the WordPress, as we don't need it anymore. It's working fine, but we want to see that if the Helm is also able to remove the installation as well. So Helm delete my WordPress, and it does. And if we run Helm list again, it shows nothing. So this is the perfect way to configure the K3s with Helm tool. I hope that you really learn a lot from this video. Feel free to ask me the questions in the comments. I will be really happy to answer all of your questions, and see you next time. Till then, bye bye.